It's going to be, how do you think people are going to take to it? Do you think it's going to be, I mean, it also depends, because if people attack it, like they already are attacking it, it's going to bring more attention to it and it's going to bring more followers to it. But it's going to be interesting if they're going to launch like infrastructure attacks on
it. If Trump is on it, the media will be forced to be on it. These journalists will have no choice because Trump will be posting and they have to cover it.
I forgot about the Trump reply guys.
Yeah. Yep. They want their jobs back.
Jeff.
Jeff. He was like, I remember he tweeted something about almost quitting. And then he's like, I got to figure something out because I don't have anything other than Trump. My identity is defined by him.
There was entire careers built off replying to Trump tweets.
Oh, man.
There's how entire books. There's books horrible. Being sold of all of his tweets right now that are sold out.
Wow.
So, again, the guy was interesting. The guy was funny. The guy knew how to get attention. And, you know, I think a lot of his trolling, a lot of his comments are desperately needed in the kind of sanitized digital world that we're living in.
I know a guy. He used to be a regular journalist. Normal dude. Little regular millennial guy. And then one day he responded to Trump. And he said something dumb. Made no sense, added nothing to the conversation, but then he got followers. And then he kept doing it. And then I was talking to him and I was like, what are you doing? Like, you know, you used to cover serious topics. And he's like, oh, I'm just, you know, responding to Trump. It's like whatever. And then after like a couple of years, he had destroyed his career completely. He was unable to, my understanding, get serious journalistic work, started working for activists. And then when Trump left, it's all over. Imagine destroying your life as a serious reporter because you found out you're getting followers by calling Trump a poo-poo head.
Wow. What a life. What a life.
It's amazing.
And it's funny, those type of people, too, those are the same people who, remember when they would say that Trump was, they were worried about if he was unfit for office, right? Now look at who we have. Huh. The guy's probably down the street getting spoon-fed in a rocking chair right now, watching John
with
Wayne
movies. With
a
blanket on his back.
Yeah, yeah. Remember when he said that? What did he call that guy? The a dog-faced pony liar.
Pony soldier.
What is that from? An old western?
No, it's
right?
not true. It's not true. So, at first the media was like, "It's actually just an old line from a movie," and then someone pulled the movie up, and it's like he took three different movies and mashed random things together. Lion, dog, face,
which,
pony,
which
soldier.
Which is consistent to his brand, basically, when he speaks.
Have you guys seen Freedom Toonz?
I like those guys.
The Rogan one?
I haven't seen the new one.
No, I haven't.
The new one is Joe Biden's greatest hits.
Oh, I got to watch that.
And it's like, through the shower of pressure coming down on me. And I'm like, oh, Seamus.
So good.
Out of the park.
I do this thing with Biden now where it's like I want to make it a whole presidential term without actually listening to what the president has to say. So I try not to get through like when he shows up on my feed, I try to cut it off before the end of his sentence, which is easy to do because he doesn't actually form sentences. So it's easy to do that. But I just feel like it's a waste of time to listen to what he's saying. He's reading from a teleprompter. He doesn't believe in what he's saying.
Well,
he has people behind him telling him what to do. This
if
isn't
he
even
can,
the Biden
let me read the teleprompter.
Let me point out the differences we have right here. Now, I can't speak for every person on the right. There's a lot of people who replied to Biden and Kamala, and it's like the weirdest thing. I find it's the most annoying thing to me, honestly. I don't care if you're on the left or the right. I'll see a tweet from like Kamala Harris and I'll click it, and then I'll see a bunch of verified like libertarian, moderate, or right-wing people just saying stuff like, you're so dumb, like you're wrong about that. I'm like, why are you playing reply guy to Biden? Like, it's just so stupid.
Why even acknowledge it? Why even acknowledge him into your life? It's like Demi Lovato thing. Like, why waste your time even letting that in?
But I will say this. When Trump would say something, people would just call him stupid. They'd say, you're evil, you're racist, you're a bigot, you're dumb. And now, you know.
Now they're like, wait, what'd you say? What?
Yeah.
Huh?
Yeah,
well, responses to Biden are like, this policy is incorrect and, you know, you're failing. But there's a lot of the same stuff. There's a lot of the same reply guy stuff. But I will say the big difference is that there's no real career reply guys for Biden. You're not going to gain followers by replying to Biden like you could reply to Trump.
Right.
And so this bred a class of people who made a living. My favorite is when like these people like Jeff, what's his face? I don't want to say his last name. Anyway, people like him who would be like, if you like my insult of Trump, please, here's my PayPal link and give me money.
That's so gross.
Here's my Patreon.
Wow. Who are these people? You know people like that?
I knew one guy.
Ugh.
Yeah, his career's over.
He must be fun at parties.
Yeah, you know what? The reality is normal, dude. These are normal people. And then I got to tell you, when you have like I can't imagine having this mentality, but this guy, he's got like 1,000 followers, which is like, you know, bottom rung. And then all of a sudden he has 2,000 followers, all because he called Trump a dumbass or something.
Yeah.
And then after a week, he's like, I'm gaining tons of followers. So what they do is they pull up Trump's Twitter and they would just refresh. And then as soon as it would come in, they'd immediately be like, oh, I got to be the first person.
What a
and
sad then, existence.
Oh, terrible.
They set up notifications. And we have to understand, big tech social media rewarded these people.
Yep.
They were able to get all the followers, all the replies, all the likes. They saw the conflict. Social media said, ooh, conflict. Let's put this up on the front page. Let's put this up so everyone sees it. And they got their response. They loved Donald Trump. They loved every aspect of him, even though they hated him, even though they said he was, they scorned him, even though they cursed him out whenever they could, even though they attacked him disingenuously whenever they could. At the end of the day, the big tech social media companies, and also let's not forget, the mainstream media loved him because he revitalized their entire careers that were already going downhill. They're going downhill right now because we have a president that barely even tweets, but barely even says anything coherently that they can't even respond to.
Yeah, it's sad. They love the divide too, which is kind of the saddest thing. That's why I feel like what we need to do, because we're always at odds. It's the left versus the right. You turn on CNN, they're pointing fingers at the right. You turn on Fox News, they're pointing fingers at the left. Why don't we just take the Northeast, the South, the Middle America, and the West Coast, and just form our own countries with our own governments and our own presidents, and you go where you fit into, and then you leave everyone the hell alone. Because it's like, what are we going to do? It's a constant tug of war battle going on. You get a Democrat in office, and then you get a Republican to undo what the previous president did.
If we're lucky.
So, you know, so I pulled up, someone commented in Super Chat, it's truthsocial.com. You can join the waiting list. So people have found ways to effectively gain access to the site. I'm going to tell you this right now. The first people to sign up for that waiting list, Reply Guys.
Yep.
Trump's sick. What's the opposite of a sycophant? Someone who walks around complaining about your farts.
Stalkers.
Stalkers.
Yeah. Objectors.
It sounds like my next video.
Trump stalkers were the first people to sign up. And you know what? I'm willing to bet they cried. I'm willing to bet they were sitting there when they heard this announcement. They just like started crying like, I matter. I matter.
Happy tears.
I can totally see that happening.
Imagine being that
I can see the keyboard wet. Like it's dripping wet right now with their tears. Because
please, Trump, please let me on your platform.
And these are the same people that called for him to get banned. Mm-hmm. And now they're giddy.
Wow.
That's what I was saying when they were talking about banning Trump. I was like, it'd be really bad for them because they need Trump to be their boogeyman.
And it has been. It absolutely has been. Because now they're the power in charge. They're the ones that everyone's looking at. Like, okay, you got everything you needed. You got rid of the bad boogeyman. Now show us what you got. And what you got is an absolute utter crap storm on huge epic proportions of financial calamities, vax mandates, more people getting sick, more people dying from the sickness than they did under Donald Trump, which they blamed for every single person that passed away. Now, more people are dying, and then Biden, he's not at fault.
We should make an account on Twitter called, like, Trump Scarecrow or whatever, and it's just like, it's a fake Trump account so that the Reply Guys have somewhere to be and to, like, you know.
It's like their safe space.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. So it's, you know, it brings them back the good old times.
The good old glory days when they were getting followers and some kind of attention. But it's mainly an attention game here. And that's the weird part, because they've been incentivized to know the dirtier, the nastier, the more disgusting they are, the more people look at them. And there's a certain point to that where people are like, ugh, you're really ugly. But there's the initial part like, oh, well, there's a car wreck over there. Let's at least look, make sure whatever's going on there. There's this kind of initial first look. So I think we reach that point where it's just utter disgust and people realize how nasty it is. And the algorithm feeds it to people. And I think a lot of people eventually, not yet, I don't think we're there yet, but I think eventually are going to be utterly disgusted with what the timeline provides for them.
Did you find Mastodon in the source, in the inspect, the code on the page?
No, I just hit inspect, but apparently it's in there. It says Mastodon.
And it definitely says it's proprietary in the terms of service.
In the terms of service here?
That's the link there.
But it's not live yet. It could be a placeholder.
Well, it's
right.
The front page is live. And if that's Mastodon code and they're saying it's proprietary, then they're violating
and all
the
source code. Well, it's just wrong. Like, what you need to understand,
it's also illegal.
This. No, it isn't.
What?
Ian, if I said, Ian, I own your coat, is that illegal?
Well, if you're wearing it and walking around town with it and I didn't give you permission, yeah.
No, I thought you were open to source.
Copy, Ian. Yeah. What do you mean? It's just a copy. It's not the real thing, right?
If source code says you cannot copy this without like Creative Commons.
Wait a minute.
I thought you're the open the source guy.
For big social networks, yeah, let's talk about it. Social network functioning in the commons,
but
the
not for this one. In the commons.
It hasn't. It's not part of the commons yet. If it becomes so ubiquitous that
no, Ian, you're wrong. He didn't steal anything. It's a copy of it.
If he copied GPL code,
but you said copying isn't theft.
It's not theft.
Oh, okay. So what's the problem?
He's violating the license.
How? It's a copy.
Because it's the GPL license. You can't copy GPL license without crediting the original source code.
Ian's a guy who came out and said piracy isn't theft because it's just a copy and you're not taking the real thing. And now he's mad that Trump copied it.
Yeah. Digital copying is not the same thing as stealing someone's original.
What?
Huh?
Sorry if that was difficult to understand.
Ian, you can't have both positions. It makes no sense.
Yeah.
I mean, so are you saying he's pirating the software? Is that what you're saying?
Sure. Let's say that's not legal, Tim. Okay.
We'll see.
If it's
are you encouraging people to take GPL code and make it private?
We don't know if that's the case. No. Exactly. Okay. Good. Here. We don't know what exactly is going on here,
and you don't know as to what on the site might be proprietary. But you said it was illegal, and the point I'm making is that, like, dude, if I tell people that I own your glasses, I didn't commit a crime by doing
that. Yeah, but if you're walking around displaying it as your own, then you are.
He's not. The site's not live.
It is. Truthsocial.com is live right now.
No, it isn't.
I'm on it.
Yeah, you're not
You pulled it up, didn't you?
You're not logged in.
Part might not be public yet.
But the Mastodon part isn't actually there.
Truthsocial.com.
Right, the Mastodon part isn't actually there.
Ian, well, you didn't find it in the inspect?
Because it's not here.
Oh, I thought you just said it was.
They got a... No, I said yes. But what I meant was... People who broke in searched the source code of the social platform and found that Mastodon was listed. Mm-hmm. On the actual site that's live, it doesn't say it as far as I know. Okay, regardless, I know Trump is it probably doing something wrong. I'm going to wait until it goes live before I start joining in on the
mainstream media.
The vomitorium Orange Man bad narrative.
Yes. When you say go live, when the front page is live, the site has gone live. Even if you can't get in and log in yet, the site is still live.
You're just trying. You try so hard to like change definitions.
I built a social network. I know what it means.
You're fighting an allegation made by the mainstream media against Donald Trump. When the right position, in my opinion, should be let's just wait. Let's find out.
Yeah, I think you're both right. I'm not going to push the issue here. Maybe he will.
Let's just wait and find out. I think that's.
I just don't understand why Ian's mad about this. I don't understand. Yeah,
it's important to me that if you use free software code, that you uphold the license.
Maybe they have a license. How do you know if they don't have a license?
In their terms, they say it's proprietary.
So maybe they have a license.
Would be a proprietary license that's not GPL.
Or maybe they have Mastodon. Maybe they have a different agreement with Mastodon. We don't know yet.
I thought Ian said he's going to sue.
This kind of private property. Like, I don't understand.
Then you thought wrong.
But you had a huge argument about IP. You said copying isn't illegal and should be allowed.
Well, I don't know if I didn't say copying isn't illegal. I said copying and stealing are different.
You said copying is okay. It's not theft because it's not the real thing.
I didn't say it's okay either. You did. I said it's not stealing. It's different than stealing. So piracy in the old days was if a pirate would go to your ship and take your stuff and you don't have it anymore. Nowadays, they make a copy of it and they call it piracy, but it's different than that old school piracy.
If I write a song and then someone copies it and then shares it with a billion people, is that wrong?
You could make that argument, yeah.
You think it is wrong?
I mean, right and wrong aren't the words I would use for it, but it's definitely not the way the system's built to be.
Well, that's the opposite of what you said, a couple weeks ago.
Ian, they're really coming down on you. I got a message from an anonymous source on my Instagram that said to tell Ian to shut up, and I have a feeling that it was Tim that sent me that, to be honest with you.
I'm making bold claims, and they need to have holes punched
in. I'm defending you. I don't agree.
What I'm talking about is extremely... It's extremely jarring to the system. So we need people to punch holes in the things I'm saying because I need to make sure that what I'm saying is bulletproof if I'm going to go forward with it.
Donald Trump should not take open source code and then lock it up and then develop on top of it while restricting access to it.
It's okay with open source, but not with free software like GPL. That's not open source code. That's free software code.
Oh, right. So he's taking freeware and then turning it into...
Not freeware. Free software licensing code. Freeware is like Diablo 1. Yeah, you can go take for free.